Jesus loves me. His name I know. For the Bible tell me so. Yes, Jesus loves me. For the Bible tell me so.
Easter Day. Here is Reese. Happy Easter Day.
Is that how to say? And happy Jesus too. Happy Easter Day. Happy Easter Day. Happy Easter Day. Happy Easter Day.
He's risen. Happy Easter Day.
See for the child born that night to be our life. Happy
Easter Day. He's not here. He is risen just as he said, Matthew 28:6.
Happy Easter. All my family.
To put others first, how to love and give. Jesus is alive, could not hold him back. Happy Easter.
It's not about the bunny, about the lamb.
Matthew 28:5. But the angel said to the woman, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was executed on a stake."
Christ the Lord is risen today, and the angels rolled the stone away from the tomb where he lay. Little children, come and sing, glory, glory to the kings, Christ the Lord is everything.
Jesus is the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world.
This is a time of love, a time of death and pain undone, so we may know the power of love that lives in each one. Each love we feel, unstained and free, redeems us as with you and me.
Remember that Easter morning. Remember, Jesus bore the stripes of pain and suffering. He bowed under the weight of the cross. He shed his blood. He said, "It is finished." He entered the tomb. He broke the bonds of death. He rose to live forever. Remember, his sacrifice, his pain, and his joy. For by the power given to Jesus to overcome death, he has proven there is no death when we put our trust in him.
Hey everybody, this is my Easter speech. Easter is life. Easter is hope. Easter is the renew of those good human values. Easter is Jesus in the heart. Happy Easter.
I serve as a risen Savior. He's in the world today. I know that he is living, whatever men may say. I see his hands of mercy. I hear his voice of cheer. And just the time I need him, he is always near. He lives. I am Sharane Littleton. Happy Easter.
Jesus is good. Jesus is great. He died for us. Oh, what a good fate. He rose again on this Easter Sunday. He loves us so much, so he gave us this.
He is risen. Death cannot hold him. Rejoice in the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Matthew 28.
Red is for the blood Christ gave. Green is for the grass he made. Yellow is for God's light so bright. Orange is for the prayers at night. Black is for the sins we made. White is for the grace God gave. Purple is for the hour of sorrow. Pink is for me tomorrow. Happy Easter.
Hey, all, I'm reading from Mark chapter 8, verse 31. He then began to teach them that the Son of Man must suffer many things and be rejected by the elders, the chief priests, and the teachers of the law, and that he must be killed and after 3 days rise again. Mark chapter 8, verse 31.
Good morning. Today I will be reciting to you John 11:25 and Acts 4:33, because I feel that they are both relevant to this Sunday, which is Easter. John 11:25 states, Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrector and the life. The one who believes in me will live, even though they die." Acts 4:33 says, "With great power, the apostles continued to testify to the resurrection of the Lord Jesus. And God's grace was so powerful at work."
This is from Acts 3:15. "You killed the author of life, but God raised him from the dead."
Let it mine. I'm gonna let it shine.
forsake us, dear God. So we thank you for being with us, dear God. We thank you, dear God, for food and shelter for them, even during this time, dear God. We thank you, God, for all of your people, dear God, especially all those that are present here today in their cars, dear God.
But you kept them just like you kept me. Can I get a witness?
Stretched and wide, he hung his head.
For me died this love. This love. But that's not how. But that's not how. The story ends. In 3 days, he rose again. This love. I don't know about y'all, but I'm so glad that he did stay in that grave. Anybody glad he did stay in the grave? And there is no greater love than a man to lay down his life for a friend. There is no greater love. Our mic's going in and out, but that's okay. We still gonna give God some praise.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
And I don't care what the devil try to do, we still glad to be here. Yes,
amen.
Lord. Amen. And you know, this morning
we checked all our stuff and everything was working just fine.
Amen. This morning we checked everything. Everything was working fine. And we got to singing about Jesus got up out the grave and the mics began to get crazy. But right, that's okay now. Because they can cancel everything else, but they couldn't cancel his resurrection. So today is a good day because this is all about the resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Resurrection day.
Amen. I know for a fact. Look at all these cars out here. The devil thought he was going to keep us in the house. How many are glad we out here? Preaching time. Amen. It's preaching time. It's preaching time. Amen. It's preaching time. Our God, our Father, we come to you right now just saying thank you. Lord, we thank you for getting up out of that grave. And Lord, we ask right now that you bless each and every one of us for just coming out trusting in your word as we continue to hold up the bloodstained banner of the Lord. Lord, we thank you for keeping us. We thank you for watching over us last night as we slumber and slept. And Lord, right now, we just say thank you because you've been mighty good to us. And because you've been good to us, Lord, we just want to take out a little time just to show you our gratitude by saying hallelujah, because we understand hallelujah is the highest praise. And Lord, right now, we ask that you bless everyone to hear our voices. And Lord, we ask that you heal those that are sick right now. Touch the bodies of those that are fever and mourn. And Lord, we ask that you fill the void in those lives that have lost their loved ones. We ask that you give them joy right now. Restore the joy in their life. Lord, we thank you for our families. We thank you for our friends. And Lord, we even thank you for our enemies. But most of all, we thank you for Jesus. And Lord, we ask that you equip us right now that men may not see us, but they will see you. And Lord, we ask that the word go forth, they be able to help someone today to hold on a little while longer. Lord, we thank you. We praise you. It's in Jesus' name we do pray. Amen. 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 Y'all, look, since y'all can't hear y'all say amen, y'all can keep them horns like we did last week. Amen. That let us know we in the house. Amen. Amen. God, we thank you again. How many of y'all glad to be alive? Amen. It's another day's journey, and I'm glad about it. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Rain. How many of y'all need the Lord to do that for you right now? Lord, we need you to open the floodgates of heaven. Y'all, but I'm so thankful this morning. because God's grace keep on watching over us. And it's not because we've been so good, but because of his grace and his mercy. And for us to get up this morning and did not receive a phone call to say that no one was dead or no one was sick, that lets us know that he's reigning on our life. And everybody that hear my voice, wherever you are, you ought to be telling the Lord, Lord, I thank you. Sleeping in our grave, but God made old Rona. He made Rona behave. How many of y'all know that he's a God of another chance? If you're like me, you messed up your one chance and your second chance a long time ago. That's why we say, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we magnify your holy name. Lord, we thank you. Hey, you died on a Friday, stayed in the grave all day Saturday. But Lord, we thank you. We thank you because early one Sunday morning, he stepped up out of the grave. He told, oh, damn. Oh, damn, you gotta behave. He told you and I now hold power in my hand. I sit on the right hand of the Father. One day you will be with me in paradise. It's raining. It's raining. Our scripture for this morning. I didn't get excited. I'm sorry, y'all, but when I think about the goodness of God, I don't care. I don't care where I am. I had to tell him thank you. If you have your Bibles, turn with me to Matthew, the 28th chapter. Matthew, the 28th chapter, the 18th verse. We'll go back to it. And Jesus came and spake unto them, and saying, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. And I'm just going to use, just for a topic, we've been hearing this on Facebook, we've been hearing this all around the world. My grandma used to say it all the time. If we just got to have a topic we'll use, he got the whole world in his hands. Yes, amen. Y'all, look, Facebook, y'all tell your neighbor by sharing it right now. Say, he got the whole world in his hands. And Galilee, while y'all in the parking lot, blow your horns and let them know he got the whole world in his hands. As we look at the scripture, we see that the morning had came and had come, and the women have gone out, and they went out to see Jesus, and they went out to prepare his body. And when the women came that morning, he was gone. And what in the world was going on? And folks was like, what is going on? And the disciples told him, the angels told him, say, why are you looking here? He has already risen. But one of the things that we notice, the disciples would never have known that he had risen from the grave if the women wouldn't have been obedient. Jesus told the women to go meet the men. And I want to tell you something. If you read the scripture, it tells us that the disciples were doubtful, but the women came to let the disciples know that the Savior now lives. Let them know that the Savior now lives. And this is why I come by to tell y'all this morning, regardless of what goes on in our life, he has the whole world in our hand, in his hand. And the reason why I know this, because it looks like to me that Corona 19 is getting the best of us. But how many of y'all know Jesus has the final say so? And that nothing on this earth take place unless he allows it to. Because if you don't mind, look at the scripture again. It says in verse number 18, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. You need to encourage somebody to let them know, even though it don't look like things going to turn around, things are going to turn around because all power was given to Jesus in heaven and in earth. God lets us know that regardless of what it looked like, he is still in charge. Somebody told me the other day, said a lot of preachers are dying right now. Well, watch this. The Bible says that when one is born, we should mourn. We should cry. But it said when one dies in the Lord, we should celebrate. Because when they leave here, to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. I want to ask you one question this morning. Are you ready to leave here? If you were to leave here right now, would you be able to tell your family before you leave? Y'all remember they used to sing this song, when you hear of my home going, don't worry about me. How many of y'all know without a shadow of doubt that if you were to leave here right now, you on your way to glory, and you can tell your family, you don't have to worry about me because I'm going to take my rest. Truly, you know, and I have to be honest with you. Yes, when you leave here, we will miss some of us, and I know some of us will be missed. I know some of people will be glad that some of us gone, but most of all, we'll be able to take a rest. But you got to understand, I want everybody to understand, listen, I learned this, and I keep on telling you this. Listen, you cannot operate off of fear. Whoever you're riding with, if you're riding by yourself, touch yourself and say, self. You can't be scared. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but he has given us a spirit of sound mind. Now somebody said, what do you mean, Knox? Are you telling people not to be safe? No, I'm telling you to be safe. I'm telling you to be precautious. But most of all, keep your faith in Jesus Christ. Your faith got to stay so strong in Jesus Christ, because watch this. I told you all this before. A lot of us have been in contact with Corona long before they told us that Corona was here. And it was God's grace that has kept us. Some of us walking around right now, we have Coronas, but we don't know we have Coronas because we've been covered in the blood. Somebody said, well, Knox, that sounds crazy. Well, I told somebody the other day, it sounds crazy for Jesus to tell the man to get out the boat and walk on the water. To me, that didn't make sense. You want me to walk on water, something that don't hold nothing up, but you have to float in it? But Jesus told him to walk on water anyway. So what I'm telling you today, practice safe precaution. Practice being a safe distance. Practice washing your hands. Practice all of the things they say, but most of all, practice believing in the Lord. Your faith got to be in the Lord, because one thing we understand, the Lord give it and the Lord take it away. And if we go back to the scripture, it says all power. And there's the thing about all. It all means that everything. It doesn't matter. I don't care how you try to explain it. If it don't make sense, it don't have to make sense. It's called faith. And I hear a lot of people saying, well, we got to have some sense. We got to have more faith. If we have more faith, we'll be able to speak to this old virus, and this virus will have to go. But we got to have faith. And if you don't believe me, it's in the book. It says that if we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we'll be able to speak to the mountain, and the mountain shall be moved. And look what the Bible says. It says right here, look at verse number 18b. It says, listen, the risen Christ makes a claim. Now, this is what I like about Jesus. Jesus ain't never been a scared man. Jesus, what he told everybody right here, Jesus came and spake. He said this. Let me tell y'all something. He said, now, y'all tried to kill me, but you couldn't kill me. I gave up the ghost. Okay, everybody remember this. No matter what the world try to do to you, no weapon formed against you can prosper, because he has all power in his hands, both heaven and earth. That means that even though folks talk about what, folks say, well, I'm going to do this. Well, if you've been protected by the angels, how many of y'all know you got an angel riding with you? Right now, you got an angel riding with you. Sitting at home, you got an angel sitting with you. How do you know? He said, goodness and mercy shall follow you all the days of your life. And as long as you're still living, you still have goodness and mercy. Well, watch this. When I look at the scripture, I found out Christ made a risen claim. He said, all power is given unto me in heaven and earth. Watch this. All power is his. The authority, the control, he has all power in his hand. And if you look at the thing about it, I was looking at it, I said, man, the word all means everything. And look, it don't mean some things, it means everything. Somebody said, well, how did he get it? When he got up from the grave, he got up with all power in his hand. If he had stayed dead, he wouldn't have had all power. But because he got up out of the grave, that lets us know that he has all power in his hand. Then watch this. He goes on to tell us that he makes a claim. Then he goes on to tell us, he said, listen, what I need y'all to do, he said, I need you to get up off your blessed assurance. Tell somebody, say, get up off your blessed assurance. He says that now that you know that I got all power in my hand, I need you to go ye therefore. And look, he said, go ye therefore. That ain't just for the preachers, that's for everybody. All disciples have to have enough discipline to understand that your job is to be telling somebody that he died, he rose, and he's coming back again. How many of y'all disciplined enough to not be scared and not to be ashamed to tell somebody in a conversation, do you know that Jesus coming back one day? How many of y'all started a conversation and say, I know you're worried about coronas, but do you know a man that can handle all of the corona disease? How many of y'all asked somebody today, do you know a man named from Galilee that came down through 42 generations, born to a Virgin Mary? Do you know this man? You got to have some discipline. We talk about everything else, we need to be talking about Jesus. Because he told us, watch this, he didn't ask us to tell. And look, if you look at the scripture, and for those of you, I think it's up on the screen right now, he said, go ye therefore. He didn't ask you. That was a command. That was a command. Everybody know a command from Jesus means that we need to be what? Doing it. And then turn around. But it ain't till he see fit that things are going to turn around. Watch this. If you don't believe that he has all power, watch this. We celebrating his resurrection. Look, when they whooped him, and they whooped him so bad he was weak, and he was marching up to Golgotha Hill, and he got there and he had a little man, they say he needed a little help, got a man out of there, put the cross on his shoulder, and the scripture say, must Jesus bear this cross alone and all the world go free? There is a cross for everyone. There is a cross for me. That lets each and every one of us know that each and every one has got a cross to bear. That means that we got to quit worrying about ourselves and start worrying about somebody else, because we got to love our neighbor as we love thyself. And when we learn how to do that, we're showing that we are like Jesus. Because listen, it wasn't the nails that held him to the cross. It wasn't the nails that held him to the cross. It was his commitment to you and I, to let us know that he loves us so much that even he was sinless, he took on our sins so that we would have the right to eternal life. And because of this, we ought to be happy today. Now, look at the scripture. It says, and he rose and said, all power is in my hand. Here's the thing that I want to make sure I leave you with. Fear will make you fight. Fear will make you fight. A scared man will kill you. Your fear can cause you to lose sight of God's promise. Everybody need to understand, if God said he has all power in his hands, you got to have enough faith where you believe his word and not have fear. Because where fear is, fear will cause you to lose your faith and cause you to act a fool. How many of y'all understand that? Watch this. Anybody ever been mad before? And because you got mad, but then when you got mad, you got scared. And when you got scared, the person that you was mad at, you got scared of them. And then you begin to lash out because you say, I got to protect me because I ain't going to let you do nothing to me. And next thing you know, you did something, you did regret it. And even to the day you think about it, you did something that you regret it. Because when you get scared, you don't start thinking about the facts. And you can't look past your situation. What I'm saying today is, you got to have more faith in God, less fear, more faith, and you can look past COVID-19, and you can see that the sun will soon shine. Well, somebody said, well, Pastor Knox, that sounds good. Well, how do I increase my faith? Well, the Bible says, faith comes by hearing. Hearing the word of the Lord. Then it asks the question, how do you hear? Except by a preacher. How do he preach unless he has been sent?
Here's what I'm telling you. If you want to increase your faith, you got to get closer to who God has placed you up under. Where God has placed you, you need to be under your under shepherd. Look, pastors, we are under shepherds. All of us say we are under shepherds of God. We are under shepherds. That means we are shepherding God's sheep. And what that means is you need to be close enough to your shepherd so that he can teach you the word of God. The problem is too many of us think we already know the word of God and don't need to learn no more the word of God. And we just hearers of the word of God and not doers of the word of God. How do you know? Because we keep on seeing all these killings. The killings come from having a bunch of churches, but ain't having no workers. We got a bunch of churches, but we need some workers. You can't be ashamed to tell folks about Christ. Yeah, come on. And let's be honest. How many of us start conversations about Christ? Very few. We talk about everything else. We need to be telling people, and listen, where there's no hope, we would do whatever we had to do to stay alive. Why? Because, listen, it's called fear. It's the fear of being without. But we want to teach people that they don't have to have fear. They can have more faith in Christ, and God will turn this thing around. Watch this. I give it up to all of the nurses, all of the doctors, all of the janitorial people, all of the policemen that are on the front line, all of the people like working at Walgreens and the pharmacy that had to have contact with these people, because it takes faith to get up and go to work. Somebody say, well, what do you mean? It takes faith in God. Because even though we got masks on, even though we got gloves on, even though we got all this stuff on, you still got to contact with these people. And look, I found out that some people, even with everything on, still coming down with the virus. So that means that you got to have faith in God to even leave your house. Why? Because you have not allowed fear to overtake you. Number two, fear will paralyze you. Everybody understand, have you ever been in the house and you heard something and you don't want nobody in there but you? And you heard something, you got scared. And when you got scared, you said, oh. And then you start telling yourself, be quiet, like somebody else talking. Be quiet. And then you notice now, fear paralyzed, you ain't gonna move. You have somebody say, now, you got all this house, but you didn't lock yourself in this room. What that's going to do? Well, that means that if they get in here, they got to come through the other door to get through the other door to get to this door. Fear has you paralyzed, and you don't move. Don't move at all. Well, same old way when I walk with Christ. The devil's job is to cause us enough fear to paralyze us. And guess what? The devil is trying to paralyze us now, and the reason why he's trying to paralyze us now, he don't want our children to be saved. He don't want none of us to be saved. And what we got to do, we got to help our young generation understand that Christ is the only way. And we got to let them know, you can still be cool and be with Christ. We got to quit selling this thing to the world that in order to be cool, you got to be all square. You can be with Jesus and still be cool. You can still be with Jesus and still live a good life. You can still be with Jesus and still have fun. If you don't believe me, you can check with Sister Belinda. Sister Belinda, she laughs, play all the time, and still with Jesus. Listen, I'm telling you, and guess what? Guess what, saints of God? People got to see Jesus in you, and you stop looking like a bulldog and start having some joy, start having some laughter in your heart. Then people believe that you can be saved and still have a good life. And that's what we got to sell. We got to sell this to our children. We got to sell this to a younger generation so that they can have some hope, because they need to know that Jesus got all power in heaven and earth in his hand. How many of y'all believe that? Then, as I close, because I'm getting ready to close, I want to get to my last point, okay? Fear will not only paralyze you, fear will kill you. Somebody said, well, Pastor Knox, how do you know fear will kill you? Well, y'all remember when the man was sitting out at the tomb and waiting on, he was sitting out there because he had been instructed to guard the tomb to make sure that nobody came and stole Jesus. Y'all remember that? when you read the Bible says that when Jesus got up out the grave, the man saw Jesus and he fell over. Bloop. Night, night. Fear will kill you. Well, why do you know this? A lot of people have had a heart attack and have stroked out because of fear. A lot of folks right now having nervous breakdowns because of fear. A lot of folks are having mental breakdowns because of fear. Fear will kill you. So how do you operate? Somebody said, well, tell me, since you said fear will kill you. Well, Pastor Knox, tell me how to get away from fear. Well, again, you got to go back to your scripture, and you got to exercise your faith, and you got to understand that you got to have more faith than you have fear. How do you have more faith? Well, again, you got to study the Word of God. You got to meditate on the Word of God. You got to pray and have a communication with God every day. And as you learn more about Christ, as you get more about Christ, you'll start having experiences in your life where you'll be able to tell somebody, I have had an individual contact and an individual experience with Christ, and there's no doubt in my mind that He will bring me through. Now, watch this. Somebody need to be willing. How many of y'all willing to tell somebody the worst thing that ever happened to you and Jesus brought you through? One of the things that we have to do, because keep fear from killing us, we got to tell these young folks, we got to tell the unsaved, listen, this is what happened to me. And I don't mind telling people what happened to me. I tell people all the time, this is what happened to me, because God used my situation as a testimony for me to help encourage somebody else. Anybody else had a situation and needed, and God used your situation as a testimony so that you can help somebody else? Anybody ever been through something and you went through it and God brought you through it, and then somebody came along and was having the same problems and God used your situation to encourage somebody else? Well, watch this. This is what He's doing. This is what He's using us for. Go ye therefore, teaching them to observe all things. You got to tell folks, listen, when I had a brain aneurysm, it wasn't the doctors. It wasn't the doctors. It was the grace of God. It was the grace of God that healed me while I flew in on a helicopter and drove home the same day in a car. That lets somebody know you may be sick, but God can heal you if it's His will. Understand, we got to make sure when we're teaching this and we're telling people this, we got to make sure we understand that it has to be His will. Because if it ain't His will, then it won't be done. And when we pray, we say, let thy will be done. And the thing about it is, a lot of times when we pray, we say, God did not hear our prayer. God always hear our prayer. He don't always answer our prayer the way that we think He ought to answer our prayer, but He always hears our prayer. That's why we got to let people know God always answer prayer. And when people get this, watch this. When people get this, they're no longer operating out of fear. Now they're operating on the power of knowing who Christ is. And when you know who Christ is, you'll walk different. You'll talk different. You'll even look at things different. Things won't look the same when you understand who Christ is. If you know that God has brought you back, if you know God has healed your body, even when you get sick, you'll say, by His stripes, I'm healed. Matter of fact, have anybody ever had such an experience? Now, I look at things and I get a little discombobulated every now and then, and I look at situations where I say, God, why is this happening? Anybody ever been there before? God, why is this happening? Matter of fact, God, you know, I'm doing what you told me to do. I'm paying my tithes. I'm going to church. I'm doing what you asked me to do. God, why is this happening? And then you wait. You wait a little while. And then something else take place and you say, oh, I see why now, God. You got more sense than I do. Huh. He said, now you need to learn how to what? Trust me. And it goes back to our scripture. He got up from the grave. He says, all power is now in what? Given unto my hand. And then in heaven and in earth. And if He got all power, why we were? We got to operate. And listen, as I go to my seat, This is my last time. As I go to my seat, I want each and every one of us to leave here today encouraging our friends and our neighbors and our family members. Quit operating off of fear. You operate off of faith. What you do is you operate off faith. And listen, even when you practice safe precautions, you're still operating off faith, because it was faith that caused you to get in your vehicles to drive out here to sit in the car. Don't let folks have you thinking, talking about, well, you're crazy. That ain't no faith. That's just crazy. Well, you get in your car and go to Walmart. And then you get out your car in Walmart. At least you got enough faith. Here, come out here. Hear the word of God. You're showing God faith without works is dead. God, I got enough faith, and I'm going to drive out here. I'm going to sit in this car. I'm going to lift up my hands. I'm going to look at my neighbor. I'm going to encourage somebody to hold on a little while longer. Well, as I go to my seat, this is my seventh time saying that means I'm finished. The Bible says that Jesus told the women to go tell my disciples. And when the women saw the men, they told them that Jesus said he wanted to meet with them. How many of y'all understand that some of the men still doubted? Some of the men had fear. But how many of y'all understand that when you read the Bible, it says when the men were together, Jesus didn't open the door. He walked through the door. And when he walked through the door, they said the men were sitting there, and one of the men was by the name of Doubting Thomas. And y'all read the Bible, and the Bible says he told old Thomas, come on and touch me in my hand. He told Thomas, come on and touch me in my side. And look, y'all, how many of y'all understand every now and then when you begin to doubt, says that when you begin to doubt, Jesus wants you to do just what he did to Thomas. When you touch his hand, you go to thinking about that time when you felt like you ran out of money. That time when you felt like you couldn't pay your bills. That time when you looked in the pantry and you looked in the refrigerator and you didn't have much food to eat. He wants you to remember, you did not go without. He made a way out of no way. And that's touching of his hands. Somebody say, well, hold on. When you touch him in his side, anybody in here ever been sick and you seem like you wasn't going to get well? He said, touch me in my side, because when you was laying in that bed of affliction, I touched your body. I healed you. I told you to get up and run on a little while longer. That's me touching, you touching me in my side. We got to remember that he has given us everything that we need if we only trust and believe. We got to learn to what? Trust and believe, because he has the whole world in his hand. Anybody believe that? Blow your horns if you believe he got the whole world. Amen. Those of you that's sitting at home and you're trying to figure out if you have your business fixed, and you're trying to figure out that if you were to die right now, you're going home to be with the Lord. I want to encourage you right now. I want to ask you right now, if you're sitting at home and you don't know without a shadow of doubt that the Lord is on your side and that you belong to the Lord, I need for you right now is three things that you need to do. Three things you need to do. I need you to acknowledge. I need you to believe, and I need you to confess. I need you to acknowledge, I need you to believe, I need you to confess. If you hear my voice and you don't know Jesus as a pardon of your sin, acknowledge that you are a sinner. Romans 3:23, for we all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Believe. John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. See, confess with your own mouth, believe in your own heart that God has raised his son Jesus from the grave.
thou shalt be saved. If you do that, and you have done that, then you are saved. And as soon as we can get back into our churches, you can be baptized. But if you were to die right now, you got assurance that you believe in Christ and everything is going to be all right. Galilee, I encourage you all to keep on holding up the blessed banner of the Lord. Keep on talking about the goodness of Jesus. And keep on encouraging everyone that coronas can't do nothing if when Jesus is in control. Amen. And I truly believe on the news, they're showing us everybody's dying. But if you look at the news, you'll see a lot of folks going home because God is a healer. And all sickness is not unto death. So I encourage you all to stay prayerful, stay hopeful, stay safe. Keep on encouraging us to come on out the house because we need to come out the house now. Somebody said, well, Knox, they say stay at home. Well, come out your house, get in your yard, walk around your yard, do some exercise, move your bones, move your joints. Quit sitting in that house up under your blessed, on your blessed assurance. Get out, because the way that this disease works, the disease works because it get into your lungs and it causes you to the mucus start to multiply, and then you can't hardly breathe. But if you stay active, you got to stay active. You got to stay active, and you got to keep your blood pressure down, and you got to keep your cholesterol down, and we got to do that because all of this is part of being saved. Amen. This is our morning message, our evening message. We thank you all.